Good morning, friends and fellow traders. This is Doug Campbell with Right Way Options, and this is the morning market prep video for December 1st, 2021. Well, my goodness, the Fed really upset the apple cart yesterday. We were already kind of reeling from uncertainty about the new variant out there. And then the Fed comes in testimony to Congress, telling us that they expect inflation to stay strong well into next year, and that they are going to start doing a little bit more aggressive taper. And that sent the market into a tailspin, breaking through support levels, creating significant technical damage in a couple of the index charts. So what does that mean for today? Well, how about we settle in, let's buckle up, and let's get ready for the Wednesday hump day edition of the morning market prep video. Well, good morning once again, everyone, and thank you so much for being here. I truly appreciate it. Let's take a look at these charts and see if we can gain some information about how we might want to approach the market for today. So I mentioned significant technical damage. My goodness, when you look at the diamonds, you can certainly see that. It was just not that long ago we were talking about the diamonds just breaking through downtrend, creating this first lower high in the chart, and then we have just nosedived in a very steep decline here in the Dow. So we've been slicing through support levels like they weren't even there. And one of the significant ones is right here. And then yesterday we sliced through support right through here in the chart and dove right down in here. And I thought there may even be a chance that we could come down in here and test this level. Now this morning we're seeing some relief, a little bit of a bounce back here in the market. But let's keep in mind, we have created significant resistance levels in the chart. So we have resistance right through here. We have the price resistance of the gap right in here. So as we rally back up, we're going to want to be watching those resistance levels in the chart. And probably the biggest problem will be when we rally back up into this downtrend. And this price resistance level, we have created a fairly significant level of price resistance here in the chart. So that gives us plenty of rally back, but still gives us a little bit of concern here in those charts. So I do think we should expect a bit of a relief rally from this oversold condition, but don't just go blindly rushing in thinking that we will never sell again. As a matter of fact, I think there's so much uncertainty out there, we should be prepared for quite a little bit of volatility to remain, which means that we could see intraday whipsaws, we could see pop and drop patterns in the morning, we could see overnight reversals based on news events. So watch carefully and make sure you plan your risk carefully in this chart moving forward. Now I know there are a lot of people expecting a Santa Claus rally, and that could certainly be the case. But when we take a look at some of those retail numbers, the retail numbers are suggesting that, well, the inflation is keeping people from spending just a little bit. Those sales numbers declined. And what that might mean is instead of the Santa Claus rally, we might see a little bit of a Grinch show up this year. So watch carefully. I don't think we're out of the woods here yet. And just don't blindly buy the dip. Let's take a look at the SPY technicals. By the way, I failed here to mention our technical problems here in our chart. Notice that we dropped significantly through our 50-day moving average. We came within a breath of the 200-day moving average. And what's interesting about that is I would not rule out the possibility that we could still see that 200-day moving average. So keep a close eye on that. As we rally back toward this 50-day and that resistance level, that could be the challenge. Getting back through that level. And then let's take a look at that SPY, SPY. SPY did suffer a little bit of damage, but I got to tell you, with big tech, and it really is big tech, almost solely a handful of giant techs that have been able to hold the market. pretty interesting situation here in these charts. But we did break some support levels in this chart, and we will have to deal with those support levels as resistance as we rally back. So kind of keep an eye on that. And we still can't rule out that possibility. If we happen to stumble again, a retest of these lows. Remember, it's pretty common that when we break down, we'll rally and then we retest with either a little higher low or we retest that low in that double bottom. True V bottoms are relatively rare in the market. Now, that being said, with big tech being as strong as it is, there is a possibility that we could see that V, more of a V-type bottom here in that tech sector. But there is something coming along that could cause a little bit of trouble with that as well. So let's take a look at that here in just a second. So technically, we're holding up pretty well, and notice that we held above our 50-day moving average. So watch these resistance levels as we rally back up. And then if we take a look at the QQQ, man, it's almost like nothing happened in here in the chart. However, we do have a little bit of a pattern here we want to be paying attention to, and that is that possibility of a head and shoulders pattern starting to develop here in the chart. Notice that we've broken through the upside trend, so we've run into a little bit of trouble here, but nothing major. And as we rally back up, we want to be watching these resistance levels in the chart. Can we push right back through? Remember, we do have a support level in here, and we held that pretty strongly. So no particular worries here yet in the NASDAQ. But again, I'm going to show you something here in just a moment that could maybe upset that apple cart as well. Let's just jump right into that, as a matter of fact. If we take a look at bonds, tech companies are very sensitive to bonds. And we're going to see TNX, the 10-year treasury, spike up a bit this morning. We had a pretty good sell-off on that yesterday, but we're going to see that push back up. As a matter of fact, we bumped above 1.5%. So as bonds continue to rise with Fed potentially tapering, we've got a big bump coming in the 30-year this morning as well. So keep a close eye on that. If bonds continue to rise, remember, tech is very, very sensitive to higher borrowing rates. So watch carefully. That could upset things here. So far, we've been able to ignore it because the bonds haven't really escalated a lot. But with the Fed tapering and the possibility of raising the possibility of interest rate increases, you might want to watch those closely because that could be a little bit upsetting to the NASDAQ. And then if we take a look at IWM, IWM definitely has some technical damage here in the chart. We've broken a year's worth of price support up here that we broke through and just couldn't hold. We also broke the upside trend here in the chart. We are catching some price support levels in here and trying to bounce back up. But let's notice we have created an awful lot of price resistance above in this chart, including that downtrend. So as we rally back up, watch that closely for those potential rejection areas in the chart and the challenges that we have ahead of us. If we take a look at the technicals here in the chart, notice that the IWM even slashed right through its 200-day moving average in the chart. So we've got some work here for recovery in that small cap sector. Let's take a look at our VIX. Now, our VIX surged pretty strongly yesterday. But it didn't set a new high, so that kind of gave us that little bit of hint that we might be reaching that oversold condition and that a relief rally bounce may be on the way. But let's keep a close eye on this. Today we're going to pull this back significantly, but we're going to want to watch this area right around this 20 handle. There is a lot of price support in the chart around that area, in that 20 handle area of the chart. And what will be a concern for me is if we pull back, but if we continue to hold elevated in that VIX, then we still have that opportunity for those uncertainties to come along and maybe that Grinch to show up rather than Santa Claus this year. So watch carefully in the VIX. And then if we take a look at our T2122, this gave us probably our biggest hope that we could bounce. Notice we've been dancing around down here at the lows. We've been scraping along the bottom. And this is in a pretty extreme oversold condition for the short term. So what that means is a bounce or a relief rally is likely. And we're seeing those futures gap up this morning in response to that. Watch that carefully. One of the things that we could see is this spike up really quickly here, and we could be right back up here in that bearish reversal zone. And that's what we've seen here recently, where it's just a rush into risk. And if we rush too fast, sometimes we set up our own problem here in the market with that big pullback based on any news event or still the uncertainty of the new variant. Let's take a look at our T2107. Now, I got to tell you guys, this is not at all bullish in the market. 35% of the stocks holding above their 200-day moving average. Now, we're getting a false impression of the market with big tech doing the majority of the lift here and just a handful of big tech. So I want you to notice just how much weight we have pulling down on the market, and we've broken support levels in this chart. This is a pretty bearish situation in T2107. Now, that means that we have a lot of work to come back, and if we can get that relief rally and get back above some of these resistance levels, we still have a lot of work to do to lift some of these stocks out of the basement here, drag them up off the bottom of the ocean. And if we can't get more involved in the market except those big giant techs, that could be tough. We need to see a little bit more of a broader based rally overall. T2108 shows us exactly the same thing. We had a pretty significant break here with the number of stocks holding above their 40-day moving average. Notice only 27% of the stocks holding above their 20-day moving or 40-day moving average. That's a significant downturn and could require an awful lot of work to come back. And let's kind of keep in mind that as we continue to rally, notice we've had this problem, fewer and fewer stocks being able to make those new record highs in the market. And that could mean we could be reaching that point of trouble here. I'm not saying that we have to fall, but we could go into a long-term consolidation as we try to recover out of some of these extreme lows in a lot of stocks. Let's take a look at our T2101. As I've mentioned before, one of the concerns that I've been worried about here in T2101 is that break of the downtrend, and we have got that break. Now, what's going to be interesting in that downtrend break is if it were to hold a higher low. Now, I honestly don't expect this first breakthrough to hold the higher low, but it's possible with the uncertainty that we have out there. If we were to hold a higher low in here, hold above some support levels and start bouncing higher, that's where the real selling could potentially come into play. However, if we can calm this down, if we can push back, if those bulls, if Santa Claus does show up this year, we could push back down and we could continue to wind in this wedging pattern for a period of time still. We still have plenty of time to build that wedge out. So watch that carefully. Let's take a look at our economic calendar for today. And we do have a few things that we'll want to be paying attention to today on that calendar. Take a look right here. I'm going to do a quick refresh on this. We had a major decline in mortgage applications this morning. As a matter of fact, I think it was a 15% decline, negative 7.2, a massive decline in mortgage applications. nations. Again, showing those potentials that our economy is slowing, that inflation is having impacts. Now, keep in mind, we still have ADP that will be coming up probably before you actually see this video. So keep an eye on that. Private payrolls is always an important number to pay attention to. PMI and ISM. Now, both PMI and ISM are expecting modest declines in those numbers. So you'll want to pay attention to those. If we happen to miss on those numbers substantially, that could be a little bit of a bearishness coming in the market. If they come in stronger than expected, of course, that would be bullish. And then we have Jerome speaking again today in Congress. So we know what kind of volatility that can create. We've got petroleum status and that beige book later on today. So watch carefully for those. Keep in mind, guys, that as we progress here, we're going to start thinking about some jobs here at the end of the week and that employment situation number. Most people expect that to come in pretty pretty strong, so keep a close eye on that. Let's take a look at our earnings calendar. Now, our earnings calendar, we have just a little bit of, we continue to lighten up on that earnings calendar, but we have a few notables today. 26 companies on the calendar. And several of those are unconfirmed reports, but we do have stocks like Five Below that will be reporting today. It looks like they're trying to perk up just a little bit this morning, and I can't tell you if that's a result of their earnings report. Notice they're holding some support here. I don't know if that's a result of earnings report or if that is a result of just the bullishness coming into the market this morning, but keep a close eye on that. CRWD will be reporting today. This has been in an ugly downturn. We need a good report here to start picking that up. We will hear from RY today. Obviously another ugly chart to look at. SNPS will be reporting today. Now, this has been holding up very, very well, so watch in here. A bullish report could send that higher. And how about Snowflake? Snowflake is another that we've just made a lower high here in that chart. This could be an important earnings report today. So watch that carefully. Now, keep in mind, we had CRM last night. Initial reaction in CRM, pretty ugly here in the chart. But what we've seen lately, when a company misses on earnings, we just immediately start buying it back up. We'll see if that happens again here in CRM this morning. So watch that carefully. If you want the full list of notables, please click the link below the title of the video. That'll take you back to the morning prep or to the morning blog, and you can catch that full list of notables. Guys, I'm running out of time here this morning, but let's take a quick look at some stocks setting up. But before we do that, guys, if you could do me a quick favor, if this is the first time you've seen these videos, click that subscribe button on YouTube. Also click that bell icon, and if you feel like the video was worthy, please make sure to crush that thumbs up button and leave a brief comment. It's that engagement that helps the channel to grow. And once again, I just want to do a big shout out to those of you that are taking advantage of the Buy Me a Coffee link, supporting the channel that way. You guys are awesome. Thank you so much. I truly, truly appreciate it. Please keep your ear to the ground. I'm going to be doing that 25,000 giveaway. I think what I'm going to be doing is creating a live event on YouTube. So watch for that. And I'll make it sometime in a mid-afternoon where a lot of folks will be around. So you could come in there and we'll do a drawing and give away one of those carvings that I do. So thank you, everyone, and I want to wish you all a great day in trading. Now let's take a look just really quick at a couple of these charts. Take a look at Ford. Gotta say, Ford held up pretty darn well yesterday, hanging in there nicely in this nice little consolidating move. If we can get that bullishness to come in the market, I'd keep an eye on that. If that could pop through that area up there, that could be pretty significant. So keep a close eye on that. I think it would be a good idea to take a look at energy. We had oil prices surging overnight. Now, with this pulled back, and we've even had a report, I think it was Jefferies or something, that came out that is suggesting that oil could hit $150 a barrel. So keep an eye on this. We could see oil sector start to surge right back. There may be some good stocks in there for you to take a look at. And if you take a look at some of these stocks, there's really been no technical damage here in these charts, like Devon Energy. Nice little hold in here on this consolidating move. So watch for that opportunity. That could push right through to the upside. Keep a close eye on it. Good looking chart overall. You might want to take a look at Plug. Now, Plug, I have a bias on this because I am still holding this as a long trade. And as you can see, held support in here. We've had some challenges with this volatility, but holding support in there, if we can get some bullishness coming into the market, there's no reason to believe Plug couldn't bounce right off of that support and start moving higher. So keep an eye on that. You know, I think I mentioned Ford. I would be a little bit remiss if I didn't mention General Motors. Now, General Motors has had a pretty substantial pullback here in that chart, but watch it carefully. If it can hold this level right in here of support, it may come around and start showing a little bit of bullishness overall. Of course, we're going to have to mention the big techs. AMD, take a look at AMD. It's almost as if nothing has happened here in the market. So keep an eye on that AMD holding very, very strong, beautiful upside trend. Watch for that opportunity that could perk on up. I saw Cisco. Cisco, this had a bad earnings report, and this is one of those examples where we punish them hard. As soon as the earnings happen, though, we start buying them right back up. So notice this rejection here in the low, and Cisco trying to perk up here. We've got some resistance above to be concerned about, but let's watch this. If that bullishness comes in and big tech continues to be the leader in the market, then watch for that opportunity that could pop through and continue moving to the upside. Kind of an interesting chart there to be paying attention to. I think it might be a good idea to still keep an eye on just a few of these consumer defensive type stocks. Yesterday, PepsiCo had this really ugly sell-off here, breaking support. But notice this morning, it's bouncing right back in the gap up here this morning. So watch that carefully. PepsiCo, good divvy payer, that kind of thing. You might want to keep an eye on some of those defensives and see if they can't come along and push to the upside. And I'm going to have to put some utilities in that mix as well. The utilities got hit hard yesterday, but they've been holding up really strongly overall. They got drawn into that selling yesterday. Now, I don't know if they can push back up here or not, but watch that carefully. If they were to push up, there's been some stocks like NEE that have been very, very strong here in that sector. Notice this nice little hold in here. And even though it got hit pretty hard yesterday, we're holding an upside trend and we're seeing bullishness here this morning. So we could see some of those utilities coming back around to the upside for that little more of conservative type play for the market. So with that, everyone, hey, I want to wish you all a fantastic day. I want to wish you great results in your trading. Everyone, take care, be safe, and we'll see you right back here bright and early Thursday morning. Have a good one, everyone.